What's some of the things you look for when you're tuning a piano?
Well, when I'm tuning, I'm listening to make sure that it's not drifting. You know, there's a tuning that you do, and it's supposed to stay that way, so I have to be able to tell quickly if it's drifting. I'm listening for unisons, nice clean unisons. And listening for noises.
Noises such as?
Anything. Just anything weird that I don't like.
Well, I hope you don't find anything you don't like.
Yeah, me too. Thank you.
It's been a busy day. What are you doing? You being smart?
How many years have you hosted the Virginia Warings?
Actually, the first time was 2 years ago. Was the first time I got involved. And, of course, I've known Virginia Waring for quite a while, and I absolutely love and adore her, and anything with her name on it has got to be perfect.
My name is Jason Bay, and I'm from New Zealand, and I've been playing piano for 10 years now.
Where in New Zealand?
I'm from Auckland.
So you had a long trip here.
I sure did. 24 hours. This is my first international.
Do you think you'll be nervous?
Yes, I think so. Yep.
I'm Stephanie Kai. I'm 10 years old. I've been playing piano for 5.5 years, and I'm from Oregon.
Do you know each other then?
Yeah.
As friends?
Yeah.
And do you get nervous during competition or no?
No.
And have you competed before?
Yes.
Have you competed against your friend?
Yes.
And how do you feel about that?
Fine.
My name is Chris, and I'm 12 years old. I'm from Cerritos, California, and I've been playing piano for about 6.5 years. Yeah, 6 years.
What do you like most about it?
Well, I get to express my feelings. That's like, yeah. If I'm like sad, I can play a sad piece. If I'm happy, I can like play.
How often do you practice? How many hours a day?
Well, like every day. Sometimes I don't practice that much because like sometimes I feel like if I practice the same piece over and over again, it gets boring. But then like about every day I play about like 1.5 hours to 2 hours.
And do your mom and dad have to keep after you to play, or do you play on your own?
Well, they have to remind me to play every day. Yeah.
And who is this little fella?
I shouldn't have done that. We're twins.
You're twins?
No, we're not twins.
Well, this is Wesley, right?
No, he is Wesley.
You're Wesley?
Yeah. He is Kempis.
No.
See?
No, aren't you Wesley?
No, he's Wesley!
Who's Wesley?
Him!
My name is Dejane. I'm from Cincinnati, Ohio. I'm 15 years old, and I've been playing the piano for 10 and a half years.
What made you start?
My dad wanted me to study piano, so he found a piano teacher for me that lived 30 minutes away, and she was a really nice teacher, and she helped challenge me, and she pushed me.
I'm from Calgary, Alberta, and I've been playing piano for 6 years.
And is this your first competition?
No, well, international competition, yes, but no, I've done other competitions in Canada.
Do you get nervous or are you cool during the competition?
I have a lot of fun and it's very fun being in Palm Springs, that's for sure.
Have you been here before?
Excited. No, never in the States actually.
I'm Danielle. I'm from Palo Alto, California. I'm 17 years old and I've been playing piano for about 11 years.
And what made you start playing the piano?
Well, initially of course it was my parents, but once I got older it was me who decided obviously to continue playing.
My name is Weston Mizumoto, and I'm 12 years old. I'm from Southern California, Yorba Linda, and I've been playing piano for about 4 years now.
What do you like most about the piano?
I like being able to express your emotions in the music that you play.
Wesley, how do you like the hot dog?
That's Bruce.
That's who?
That's Bruce. Bruce is eating the hot dog.
Bruce is eating the hot dog. Oh, I thought you were Bruce.
Oh, you said you knew who was who.
Hi, I'm Colton Paltier. I'm from Hastings, Minnesota, and I've been playing the piano since I was 3 years old.
And how do you deal with any nervousness or any tension that you feel?
I don't get that nervous. I usually don't get nervous. For competitions, on TV interviews I do.
What do you do for fun other than play the piano?
Swimming, in here is playing the golf, playing the putting.
Putting for golf.
For the golf.
For fun. You try to practice putting.
How'd you do?
It's okay.
That's okay.
You made progress.
Cincinnati. I've been playing piano for 8.5 years, about.
So you started playing before you were 3 years old?
Actually, I started at about 3.
I'm from Honolulu, Hawaii, in the U.S.
How often do you play? How many times a week?
Every day.
I'm Paige Moon. I'm from Anchorage, Alaska, and I'm 16 years old, and I started playing piano since I was 5.
Vijay Venkatesh, and I'm from Laguna Niguel, and I've been playing for almost 12 years.
And when you're playing, for instance, what's going through your head other than trying to remember the notes?
Usually it's about texture, tone, variety of sounds, what the composer was thinking of when he composed the piece.
Texas, and I'm 11 years old, and I've been playing piano for 8 years.
That means you started when you were 3.
Yeah.
And if you win, what would your acceptance speech be?
I'd like to thank all the little people and my mom.
My name's Serena Zhang. I'm from San Diego in California, and I'm 11 years old. And then I started the piano when I was like four and a half. What I like most about music is that you can express all your feelings through it. And then you don't have to care about what people think about you. You just do your best because you like music.
Get a little bit older, what do you want to do, or what do you want to be?
Maybe not a concert pianist, but like I really want to be an accompanist, or an author, or I could be a professor in music. Yeah.
I'm Brian.
Brian, tell us where you're from and how long you've been playing the piano.
Yeah, I'm from China and I've been playing more than 10 years.
What city in China?
Shenzhen, Guangdong province. Yes.
And you must love the piano.
Sure, of course. Yeah.
I think we finished correctly.
Very good.
Thank you very much.
And tell us who you are.
Hello.
Hello.
Let me translate. It's my
father.
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 English. You can do this.
I speak
English a little.
Thank you.
Thank you.
What would you tell your son as far as a piece of advice for the next week or so?
Well, if he do his best, just, you know, give it his all, and we're proud of him.
Just have fun, enjoy yourself, and learn as much as you can about everything, not only about music.
Just remember what your teachers have taught you. Everything.
To concentrate on stage, to feel fun to play is most important. To laugh what you're doing. If you have fun, everybody will have fun.
Just enjoy. Enjoy the music, enjoy Palm Desert, enjoy the relationship here, people. Enjoy.
Just be yourself, you know, go for it. And
do the best you
and
can.
Have fun.
It's a long process and it's not any one event, so you just take things as they come and you try and learn from everything that you do.
Just relax, keep the relax and breathe. That's what teacher always says, just, you know, relax, enjoy it, have fun.
Just to play from her heart.
This is Joel Hochberg, who is making a video of the competition, and what he's doing is trying to elicit the passion that people feel for playing the piano. And he said he would very much like to get any comments you would make about what you look for in contestants.
Now, get the body involved! Yes. Don't sit there like a... Get involved!
An emotional connection with the music from the very beginning.
For me, a sense of the sound as well. I think it's very important that they listen in a way that they project. They don't play just for themselves all the time.
I think a sense of joy in the music and the fact that they are communicating this wonderful music to listeners in their audience. And this takes a lot of experience, so this is one more experience along the way. It's the expression of music as they have been inspired by it.
I certainly agree with all of my colleagues, but I would add the idea of a language, that there's a there's something that's being said through music, and so for these students, they're young and they're still learning the language, and some of them have a more innate capacity to understand it than others. Some will learn it eventually, but it's a matter of finding those people who seem to be the most that have the most to say.
We don't vote against anybody. We vote for some people. So I think it's very important to know that, because sometimes people feel like, some people at this moment, we do the competition all over again, it would change probably the different people that would be more convincing and things like that. So we have to go with who we reacted to the most in this first moment. Thank you.
Asian parents are very strict in general. I don't know if I am, but in general, I think they're very strict. And by learning how to play piano, it requires a lot of discipline to progress. And so as you get over the next level, it takes a lot of discipline. And that discipline transfers over to any other endeavor the child might have in the future. So that's a very good character trait to instill in your child. And a lot of Asians believe that, I think.
The Asian countries have taken to Western music with an enthusiasm that is most heartening, because where we as a culture have a lot of choices with computer games and sports, and some of our young people are not doing as much classical music, the Asians have put Western classical music at the center of their education for their kids and of their culture. And it's provided a vital life force for the entire Western cultural heritage.
I think it's a cultural thing. The families support it. They encourage the students to do it. They know it's important to their life. And I think the American people don't have that same commitment to the cultural life. In fact, a lot of us think it's just a fringe activity, where I think the Asian people believe it's really part of their education. And so they support it more than we do. It's too bad. We should do it more.
We're with the Bakers, and the Bakers are from?
Overland Park, Kansas.
Overland Park, Kansas.
Overland Park, Kansas.
Yes.
We're a trio. And how did you get to the Virginia Waring from Overland Park, Kansas, here in the middle of the desert?
We came here on vacation and noticed the information in the newspaper, and we came over to watch the kids play, and we have been here for 3 days and here for the program tonight for the finals.
And sir, what do you think of what you've heard so far?
Well, we're looking at 34, 21, 88.
Height.
Don't have a favorite yet, but the Bach and Beethoven and Mozart is beautiful.
And when is the Virginia Waring, do you know, when is it coming to Kansas?
We don't know that, sir.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Stuart Gordon, and I would like to welcome you to the Virginia Waring International Piano Competition, year 2007. These are the finals for the solo division for the junior and intermediate pianos. In the semifinal rounds, there were five in each category, and they played a full program. Out of those five, the three were chosen for the finals tonight, and in each category, they will vie for first, second, and third prizes. Now, it's time to begin our competition with the first young artist.
musician, and I think overall it was a great night. Wonderful kids. It's a hope that we can all retire with generation like this.
And next we have the third prize of $500.
Mike, thank you.
But third prize of $500 in the junior solo division. And this prize is awarded to TJ Tarjo. The second place winner in this division is Aaron Kurtz. There's not much suspense but it is a prize of $2,500. With this prize comes a recital at Snowmass Village in Colorado and a recital at the Rancho Mirage Public Library. Here to present this award is Virginia Waring, if you would come forward. And it goes to Jan Lisesta.
What do you think, after all is said and done?
Well done, yes. Finally we can go enjoy swimming pool without worrying about practicing for next day. I couldn't be more happy for him. He seems very content, yes, and it was a great night.
General personality is a very warm personality. He doesn't have any arrogance, which I really appreciate, even though he's had number of successes, numerous prizes in the last 2 years that we've been together, and yet he's very humble. He stays very centered, and what he does is he just enjoys playing and performing, and that's why he does it. And he's really not so much concerned about how many prizes he's going to win or making it into an Olympic sport, but rather he wants to communicate with audiences, and that's one of the greatest reasons why we're here.
Intensive training when he was a very young age, and we did that in Shanghai, and I almost give him every day, give him a lesson, you know, sometime every other day, so he is on the right track to, you know, where he wants to be, I hope.
I was in another world, this last one. I really did. I've never heard anything like that in my life.
How about you?
It's just phenomenal. I can't believe it. I've never heard anything like this before.
The third prize of $500 to Christine Kemp. The second prize in the intermediate division goes to B.J.
Mm-hmm. It has been very difficult entering two categories, and in the same day he has to participate in the concerto in the solo category, and I think he has done remarkably well given the circumstances, and he's been commuting, by the way, and still going to school this week. Since he has had a very difficult time getting off school, he went to school on Monday and he's been commuting from Laguna Niguel, so I'm really impressed with his endurance and the way he has focused and still be in the competition and being at the highest level.
And our grand prize, first prize in the intermediate solo division, is $2,500. And it also includes a recital in San Francisco, which is sponsored by the Ross McKee Foundation, and a recital in Denver on the concert series of St. John's Cathedral. Wai Xin Zhou.
And how, if I wanted to play like you, how many hours a day do I have to practice?
Maybe three hours.
7 hours a day.
A little bit.
And have you ever been in a theater this big, this large to play?
No. And I've never worked with an orchestra, so this is my first time.
And is this, had you met with the conductor before, or this is the first time?
First time. I don't know him.
Where you're really by yourself a lot, keep pushing it, and if you feel like the tempo started to drag in here, come back in and keep moving it, and I'll try to call you. Let's do a little bit of it. You want to do it? Is that the main thing?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do that right now.
Quite different from that working with a second piano. It's totally different, and you need to just follow the orchestra, because the orchestra is 80 people, or I don't know. But it's feeling really good, but you need time to really get better. Yeah.
And one of the things I heard you mention is you wanted to go faster.
Yes.
In which movement?
First movement, because I I need to show the audience or the judges energy, you know. The opening must be great.
Yeah.
What about the ending?
You saw it, no problem, right? Yeah.
Every one of the six contestants has come out on the stage from the moment they start playing. You see a definite excitement in the orchestra's eyes, and actually brings up the level of the performance of the orchestra when they hear these kids.
And how does it work from the, you're going to play six concertos,
right,
and from the, they're playing from the first one that starts it to the sixth one that ends it. How do they keep their energy and their focus up? The player, your players?
That's a very good question. We had that long rehearsal yesterday where we did all six, and we had to do a lot of it again in a rehearsal setting, and they really made it through with a lot of energy. So our plan today was rehearse very little and still hopefully be able to play the three-hour performance. I think that they're going to have a lot of energy this afternoon. I think yesterday was a difficult day. I think it's going to be fun this afternoon. So
looking forward
should be
to
fun.
It.
Thanks.
Thank you.
who are you rooting for? You can tell us, and I won't tell anyone, but who are you rooting for?
Weston Mizumoto.
Say that again.
Weston Mizumoto.
Now that's a friend.
Yep.
Which is $500, goes to Sarita Zhang. The second place, of which is $1,000, to Weston Mizumoto. And our first place winner will be performing with the Lamont Symphony in Denver, Colorado, conducted by Lawrence Golan, and receiving a prize of $2,500. This is no surprise to you, it is Colton Peltier.
The music play in my mind and just really focus on the music and don't worry about anything else that's going on in the audience or yeah.
First prize.
What group?
Symphony.
What group?
In the concerto, in intermediate. Do you
intermediate.
Know who won?
Yeah. I don't know who.
Which involves a solo recital, a performance with the Gulf Coast Symphony, and some in-school programs. And the winner of that is Brian Lynn.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
Wonderful, wonderful. How does it feel?
My brain's empty. I don't know. You see my check?
No.
Okay.
Oh wow, that's a lot of money.
I didn't see it.
How many yen?
$25. No. Oh, there's two zero.
2500.
Okay, 2500.
It's his father, his biggest fan.
Yeah. Right here today.
Junyao, congratulations. Wonderful performance. You were just wonderful. Just wonderful.
So what do you think of his performance?
I thought it was one of the best I've ever heard him. And it made the second movement made me cry. I'm so proud of him.
How did it feel up there? Now, had you played before an orchestra with an orchestra
yeah.
before? So you're
Lots
used to it, you're a pro.
Yeah. Thanks. I wouldn't consider myself a pro, but
And when do the folks back in Minnesota hear about this?
I went out and called his mother right after they announced it, and then I called his piano teacher, Dr. Wirth.
And tell me what his mother said.
She said, "He won! He won!" And then Dr. Wirth said, "He won! He won!" The same thing.
I got a feeling you're going to have a lot of parties back in Minnesota.
Yeah, I'm going to have a big party when I get back.
Great. Congratulations. You're just through.
Thank you.
Thanks, Joel.
Thank you.
I feel as though I've been invited to a private screening of something that nobody else has been invited to see. It's been that special. Pre-release, if you will, of a movie. But in this case, a piano competition. I've seen some of the best pianists I've seen anywhere.
I think it's absolutely wonderful. I so admire those youngsters who put so much time and effort, and they have, of course, a lot of talent. But it's just a marvelous, marvelous experience.
It was a really, really great experience to be, I don't know, with people from all over the world playing, and the caliber was so high. And I mean, I watched the solo finals. And
you yeah, watched the what?
The solo finals on Friday night, and it was really great to see that. And there's just so much talent everywhere. And I mean, it was a really good learning experience for me, and I'll be better because of it.
I think he's going to walk out of this event with a very, very positive experience. And coming in here, he was not after the prizes. He just wanted to perform. And this is a great venue to do that. So prizes are not the most important thing. And I really value that quality in him, that he understands it even at his tender age.
We are just tickled pink. We are so excited and so honored to be in the group with the children that he's in with. It's just an amazing, amazing thing going on.
Thank you.
wonderful. It's such an experience to be here with these young people playing. They're so wonderful. Loved it.
I've been coming 25 years and I've never heard better.